It's the Daily Dog.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back to the Daily Dog. Thanks for being with me today. Y'all, it is a Monday, and we are getting things started off right this week by making it a Metal Monday. And I am happy to get back to music by System of a Down on this episode. It has been quite some time since I previously listened to their song BYOB on the channel. And as I recall, I was quite impressed with the band's overt point of view, as well as the effectiveness of their songwriting. So when it was suggested to me that I go back and take a look at System of a Down, and I was made aware of their song called Chop Suey, and I saw that the video, the official video for Chop Suey by System of a Down, has over 1 billion views just on YouTube. And so I thought, well, crap, I need to get in on this and see what all the hubbub is about, because 1 billion people can't be wrong, can they? so that's what we're going to look at today. Chop Suey from System of a Down. This is the lead single from their second album called Toxicity. It was released in 2001. The name of the song, my friends, was originally called Suicide. So we're going to be dealing with some heavy issues today, issues of mortality and how it affects us mentally. But they changed the name to avoid a more overt controversy. So you might ask, as I did, what does Chop Suey as the title mean? Well, apparently it's a wordplay, with chop standing in for chopped in half and suey standing for suicide. So I have the lyrics pulled up here. We're going to see if we can figure out what they're talking about and what their point of view is. The very popular video that is on YouTube was filmed on location at a motel in LA. Now, I'm going to be watching the official video, but I think when I edit this video, I'm not going to show the visuals from the video. I'm just going to show the album cover. Just to avoid a visual copyright claim on this, I have gotten into some copyright issues when dealing specifically with these official videos. So I will see the imagery, but I don't think it's going to be included here in the video. So we've got Serge Tankian on vocals and keyboards. Darren Malakian is on guitars and vocals, and Shavo Odagian is on the bass, and John Dolmayan is on the drums. It's a relatively short song, but I think it's going to pack quite a punch, y'all. So let's take a look at Chop Suey by System of a Down. Here we go. Two, three, four. Just from the basic four. Using that G as a pedal tone. Not anymore. Different riff. Bum, bum, bum. G flat. A, C.
Wake up! Wake up! Grab rush and put on a little makeup! I just have to fade away the shake up! Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? Here you go, create another table! You wanted to! Grab rush and put on a little makeup! You wanted to! I just have to fade away the shake up! You wanted to! Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? You wanted to!
T, well, I don't think you do. Trust! Halftime?
My self-righteous suicide. I cry.
Really interesting dichotomy in sound. Back to this riff for another verse.
Wake up!
Wake up!
Grab brush and put a little makeup! I just got to fade away!
I just got to fade away!
Why'd you leave the keys upon the table?
Here you go!
Create another fable!
It's the same words, though, largely.
You wanted to! I just got to fade away the shake-up! You wanted to! Why'd you leave the keys upon the table? You wanted to!
Well, I don't think you trust.
I'll be darned. The second verse is like the exact same words as the first one.
Self-righteous suicide.
And this is really pretty and a whole different vibe.
When angels deserve to die.
I don't think you trust in my self-righteous suicide. I cry when angels deserve to die. Back to this riff. It's just, I think, power chords. F sharp, A, C. Why have you forsaken me in your eyes and your thoughts in your heart? These guys are effective musicians. It's not normally the sound that I go to for my own listening, but wow. It's in the same key the whole time. G minor. But they've got something to say, don't they? That was intense, y'all. Let me see if I can make something out of this as I read back through the lyrics and look at some of these notes here. A couple of things. They've got this, the verse. So there's a verse and then a chorus and then another verse. The verses are not only the same music, but the same words. Wake up, grab a brush and put a little makeup, hide your scars to fade away the shake up. And then they go on from there. And then the chorus, which goes into halftime. I don't think you trust in my self-righteous suicide. I cry when angels deserve to die. So self-righteous, what does it mean to be self-righteous? Normally, that means that we have a certainty or that we're sure of something. And normally, it's when it's unfounded for us to be certain in something. Like we're certain that we're right or morally superior, but we might be wrong. So we become self-righteous in that, right? I don't think you trust in my self-righteous suicide. I wonder if the change in tempo is showing us a difference in the point of view of the song, of who is speaking. I wonder if the verse, it's especially with the little spots where they whisper, they go, wake up, then it's in whispered, wake up, right? It's an internal monologue, maybe. And then when we get to, and it's thinking bad about yourself, wake up, grab a brush, put on a little makeup, hide your scars, and why'd you leave your keys on the table? Here you go, create another fable, if you wanted to. And then when we get to the chorus in that halftime, maybe that's speaking outwardly to the world. I don't think you trust in me. Or the way that I deserve to die. And it says, I cry when angels deserve to die. That's fascinating. I saw a quote from Darren on this, and he said that the song is about how we are regarded differently depending on how we die. And then he says this, everyone deserves to die. And I think what he means by that is everyone deserves to die with some dignity, with some understanding of who we are. And then he says this, but if I were to die from something like a drug overdose, some might say that I deserved it because of my behavior. Hence the line, I cry when angels deserve to die. Maybe that's just the judgment of society that they are talking about. I almost want to listen to it. Y'all want to listen to it again? I need to listen to it again, I think. It's a short tune. I want to see what else we can come up with this as we hear it. I don't often do this, but I'm... I'm struck with this song. So here it goes again, y'all. System of a Down, Chop Suey. Let's do it. Here we go. So that G in the bass is in all of those chords. It's a pedal tone. The chords are changing, but they're using that G to lay down. This progression, right? And then goes to these like almost no harmony, right? Bum, 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 G, F sharp, A and C.
Wake up, wake up, grab rice and put a little makeup. I just have to fade away the shake-up. Why'd you leave the keys up on the table?
Here you go, create another fable. Grab a brush and put on a little makeup. You wanted to, why'd you leave the keys up on the table? You wanted to. Why don't think you trust in? And they're saying, I'm just like you. Why do you pass judgment on me and think that if somebody like me dies, well, they deserve to, right? I think you could also. I think you could also put in an argument that this has some religious overtones with it, especially with the way that they put "Father, Father, into your hands I commit my spirit. Why have you forsaken me?" later in the song. I'll think on that, but I want to keep rolling.
Why'd you leave the keys upon the table?
He goes right back to this, right? It's not just back to the same music. It's back to the exact same routine, right? And maybe this person is just stuck in this routine where they have to wake up and put on their mask for the world. And then they feel forsaken by the world and judged by the world. And they ain't happy about it.
Self-righteous suicide.
You know, what if I wanted to escape this world? You know, because of what you've made it. You know, in their opinion. You know, don't judge me. Now they're at it. It's that same tune from before, that backing. They're making a point about how people have formed opinions about somebody, even in how they die, and they're bringing Jesus into it. Right? Even Jesus felt forsaken as he was dying. And they're equating that to how those ostracized from society might feel as well. When we are cut off and separated from the rest of humanity. It's a powerful, powerful tune, y'all. Wow. The video was quite interesting as well. They had some really amazing effects with the band in there. So if you're one of the people, a few people who haven't seen that, that's really cool. Yeah, this is a band that I think of as musicians, obviously, but also just as this is almost political speech or a speech that needs to be heard from this particular point of view. And I am happy to have heard it. It's heavy stuff, y'all, but the world doesn't make sense in a lot of ways. And these are folks that are saying that, you know, just cut it with all of the judgment and I'm better than you and I'm superior or this, that, and the other, or, you know, they were a vermin in society. They deserve to die. It's, you know, better for the rest of us. I mean, come on, let's have some empathy and let's take people at face value and consider their whole selves, right? It's a good lesson and a good wake-up call for us. A fascinating and intense Metal Monday, but I thank you for being here, y'all. We'll see you next time on another edition of The Daily Doug.